remain subjective. It was often written from the ideological perspective of the country's leaders, and it was often written in a way which was safe and was supposed to convince the public that this is how the specific events exactly happened. However, there were great minds which challenged these ideas. They seek the truth, cross the boundaries during their explorations, war and are still judged now, but at the end, they produced a working masterpieces. The famous author and a journalist, Nobel Prize winner of 2015 in literature, Svetlana Alexievich, is one of them.
Svetlana Alexievich was born on May 31, 1948, in Stanislav, Ukraine, but grew up in Belarus. Both of her parents, a Belarusian father and an Ukrainian mother, served in the Red Army during World War II and later became teachers. Svetlana Alexievich described the place where she lived as a village scarred by war, mostly full of women and widows. The author got to witness the effects of World War II from a very young age, which inspired many of her works. Svetlana: Real people speak in my books. Together, they record verbally the history of their country, their common history, while each person puts into words the story of his or her own life. Real people. Svetlana always had a passion for writing, and after finishing high school, she worked as a correspondent of a local newspaper. She graduated from Belarusian State University in 1972 and became a correspondent for the literary magazine in Minsk, the capital of Belarus. During her career, Svetlana Alexievich specialized in crafting narratives based on witness testimonies. In the process, she wrote oral histories of the most defining traumas in Soviet history: World War II, Chernobyl disaster, and the young Russian soldiers in Afghanistan. Among her notable books are The Unwomanly Face of War, which is the collection of oral testaments of women who served in the Red Army during World War II and examines their experiences and what is it like for a female to participate in the war. Chernobyl Prayer, a chronicle of the future, contains about 500 interviews of Chernobyl catastrophe witnesses over a period of 10 years. The book relates to the psychological and personal tragedy of the Chernobyl accident and explores the experiences of individuals and how the disaster affected their lives. The Zinke Boys is a tragic voice of young men who lose their youth in the Afghan War and their mothers. During her career, as Svetlana Alexievich describes her genre: I've been searching for a genre that would be most adequate to my vision of the world, to convey how my ear hears and my eyes see life. I trade this and that, and finally, I choose a genre where human voices speak for themselves. Real people speak in my books about the main events of the age, such as the war, the Chernobyl disaster, and the downfall of a great empire. Together, they record verbally the history of the country, their common history, while each person puts into words the story. Svetlana Alexievich sparked a new genre of oral history full of directness and immediacy. She writes novels of voices. She has developed this genre, book after book, constantly honoring the aesthetic of her documentary prose, which is based on hundreds of interviews. Because Svetlana Alexievich was not afraid to demonstrate the truth, many of her books were censored in the Soviet Union and later in Belarus for being unpatriotic or depicting soldiers negatively. The Chernobyl Prayer was described to be a mockery of the disaster with the elements of dark humor. Svetlana openly disagreed with the government, and in 2000 she had to immigrate from Belarus and lived in Western Europe. But she has returned back in 2010. But despite harsh criticism and censorship, many people appreciated Svetlana Alexievich. We loved Voroneyeva and supported her. In 2015, she received a Nobel Prize for Literature. Her prize motivation stated, "For her polyphonic writings, a monument to suffering and courage in our time." She was the first author of Belarusian descent to be awarded such a prize, as well as the first non-fiction writer. So, how did Svetlana Alexievich change the perspective of history and literature in the post-Soviet countries? In all of the post-Soviet republics, there was a strong censorship in all aspects of the society's lives, especially in the areas of history and the literature which was connected to this discipline. The sufferings, deaths, criticism, and desperateness could easily damage the picture of a great empire and big utopia. As Svetlana Alexievich states, history is often arrogant and dismissive of what is small and human. A whole choir sounds in my books, and people speak most beautifully in love or in death. Ordinary citizens were in the state of shock to read the books where people like them spoke, cried, and laughed about the traumas. Everything was way more different than in the Soviet history textbooks. Svetlana Alexievich opened the eyes of many people who didn't know the details in the brutal way. For the knowledgeable, she showed that the truth will spark, even in the most totalitarian regime. These books gave an opportunity for the young people to get to know about the true history. Right now, the youth desires to think independently and learn about history from different perspectives and testimonials. Not only Svetlana Alexievich honored individuals whom she interviewed, she has created a revolution. It was a small revolution, but a revolution of actual human voices, feelings, confessions, and reality which hypnotizes like a magnet, tortures, and magnetizes.
The chain will be broken and all men will have their reward.